Hey guys, welcome to the video. On this channel, we talk about personal productivity from a Christian perspective. And in this video, we're going to be talking about an app called NotePlan 3. It's an Apple app that works on your Mac, your iPhone, and your iPad, and it enables you to manage your tasks, your notes, and your calendar all in one place. It's been compared to a digital bullet journal system. And if you're familiar with bullet journaling, you'll see why people say that about this. So let's take a look. So when you open up NotePlan 3, you're greeted with this daily note, which is very similar to some knowledge management softwares like Obsidian or Rome Research. And you can definitely see that they're trying to mimic some of those features as well. So I can type here just like you would a normal note, but I also can do, if I put a little star here, I can make that a to-do. If I do a hyphen, I get a little bullet list, which is kind of fun. And just like in something like Rome Research, anything here, if I surround it with double square brackets, becomes a new note. And that's actually a physical note, an actual markdown file. And it has a backlink to the original note, which was June 7th, my daily note for it. So now anything I do in here, it has all the same settings, all the same abilities that I have in the main thing, like making to-dos, making notes, all of that, or even creating other notes within this one that are now backlinked to that. You can also do slash commands, which pull up the default markdown things, like a heading, but you could also do it just by typing the pound symbol, and it turns into a heading one, two, gets heading two, etc. If you're familiar with Markdown, you know how that works. But I like this quick slash menu that's pretty common nowadays in a lot of productivity software, that you can hit a backslash and get all of your options. And you can call up other notes that you've previously made. There's a quick menu here. See, it's autofills as I type it. And you can even embed images if that's your thing. So from a note-taking perspective, this has the basics of what you would want in a Markdown editor. Again, these are all local files, so there's a portability aspect that's really quite unique to this. There's also a nice feature within the notes thing that allows you to mention people. So you can start creating a list of people that you work with a lot. So if you're using this for meeting notes, which is majority of what I use NotePlan 2 for, was taking meeting notes at work, you can tag people in there and it begins to create an archive of any mentions that person is in. You can quickly see anywhere that name has been mentioned. There's a built-in tagging system, which you can create whatever tags you want just by using hashtags. And it works the same way, where you can see any notes that have that tag in them. So it's very robust, very handy as a note-taking software. But the real power, of course, comes from the fact that it's a to-do list manager and a calendar all at once. This is a very interesting approach. You have a lot of the best features of a personal knowledge management software, but what's baked into it is all of these to-do list capabilities. So on the to-do list, I can even schedule when this is going to be due, and that will then show up on the day that it's due. And you have your whole calendar in here. You can make events right from here. It integrates with iCal, GCal, anything else you're using for calendars. So let's go back to today. I can look at a today view, which of course just shows me what's on the list. I can look at the whole week, and so I could plan things out in advance if I wanted to from right here. Say on this day I want to eat tacos with my pal. And you can go the whole week. These arrows up here allow you to skip whole weeks at a time when you're in the week view. So it's a very quick, very fast software. And you can see your other calendars here. I have this recurring event that shows up. Any calendars will show up here right alongside your notes. And so there's a real huge value to this in terms of if you're using NotePlan 3 to plan out your week. What's coming up? What tasks you have due, and what notes and things you're taking along the way. This is new to version 3 of this, which is the review. So if you're a fan of David Allen's Getting Things Done method, you know the importance of a weekly review. Well, now they've baked it right into NotePlan. So you can see the to-dos, when they're due, you can kind of clean things up. So you can view it as upcoming. You can see which things are overdue. I don't have any overdue because I just have a demo archive here. You can see which notes had tasks associated with them. So these are tasks that were embedded within another note. So this one's in that note called Whiskers. I could jump to it from here. And you can just view everything for the week. So this allows you to clean everything up very simply. Really nice integration of that. Now, as far as a task management app, it does what it needs to do. You can create reminders, you can send notes into the future, very much like a bullet journal. If something doesn't get done today, you can forward it to tomorrow very easily. This arrow here that pops up next to any of your tasks allows you to do simple things like move to tomorrow, or you can complete the task, cancel it, or schedule it for a different time altogether. You can even create repeating tasks. So it has the basics of what you would want in a task management software. It's just kind of cool that it also shows that in line with all of your notes, just as if you had a bullet journal page full of notes and events. And I just think it's very nice to see your whole world of productivity all in one place. But if you want certain bells and whistles of an advanced task management only app like Things, which is what I use, this doesn't have everything you would want. Similarly, it can't do everything that Rome Research or Obsidian can do for personal knowledge management. It definitely can't do everything that Notion can do. So it's a little niche. If you like the idea of a simple, minimalist approach, you like that it's all in one, give it a spin. I also really love the fact that it's based on Markdown files. You're not storing your stuff on someone else's database somewhere out there, and if they shut down or they have an issue, you lose all your information. Your notes are safe and you can back them up. You could keep them in a Git repository or sync them to Dropbox, and you can use this on your phone or on your iPad. It's just a very nice all-in-one solution, and it's very fast because everything's running locally. You're not interacting with a server every single time you want to pull up a note. So NotePlan is a paid software. It's a subscription. It is $60 a year or $5 a month if you're paying yearly. And if you're paying month by month, it's $6.99 per month, which is really not a bad price for an app that does so much and brings a lot of your disparate worlds together in one place in a really nice looking way. You also get a 2-week trial before you subscribe, so you can try it for a little while, see if you like it, and cancel if you don't. And if you take a look at the roadmap on their website, they definitely are leaning a lot into the world of personal knowledge management, and this could definitely become a competitor to Rome Research and Obsidian, which would just be nuts if you had this calendar and this note-taking software and this task manager all in one, because the interface is just beautiful and I love that it's all local. So I would love to see this software come a little bit further, because I could see this definitely replacing Rome Research in my productivity software stack. So if you're looking for a digital way to keep a bullet journal, NotePlan 3 definitely has you covered, and I would encourage you to check it out. Well guys, thanks for watching. If you want more videos about a Christian approach to personal productivity, go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.